Hi everyone, here is a quick video on how to use Flipgrid when your teacher sends it to you. So this video is specific for Chromebooks. When my teacher sends me a Flipgrid and they've sent me multiple topics, I can go here at the top and I can look for the specific topic that she wants me to use. So I can click on the topics. This is the one that is kind of at the top that the teacher has sent. So once I'm in here, I usually have something here. Sometimes it's a video. It could be a Nearpod. It could just be a picture. This one is just a picture, so I can click on it to view it. And then I've got some directions here. So I can read this, or I can look for this blue button called Immersive Reader, and I can click on that, and it'll read it for me. So when I hit play,
when ancient Egyptians died,
the system reads it for me. Let's say I want to do a different language. I can click on the book and then click on translate. So I can pick any language I would like. And then I click document and that changes it all to Spanish for me. And it will actually read it to me in Spanish. Now, if I'm not sure what a word means, I can actually click on that word and it will tell it to me in Spanish. And it will also tell it to me in English. Sometimes there is going to be a picture dictionary. Now, to get that picture dictionary, I might have to change it back to English. Let's see here. There we go. Organs. So not all words have a picture dictionary, but if I'm not sure what it is, sometimes you'll see a picture and it gives me a little bit of a clue of what it is. I can also go in here and look at some grammar things. I can also look here and look at some text preferences. Maybe it's too big or too small. I can change the font and I can even change the color. Sometimes it's easier to see some of the text if it's in a different color. So once I'm here, once I've read my directions, I can actually click on some of these links that my teacher has sent me and it'll open up in different tabs. Sometimes they're going to be websites like this one. This is Metropolitan Museum of Art for kids. Sometimes they're going to be Google Docs. It all depends on what it is. And then when I'm ready, I'm going to click on the plus sign. And most of the time, it's probably going to ask me to log in either with Google or with a code that my teacher has given me. So I click on my login. It'll ask me to log in. And then it'll let me record. So here's my video. If I wanted to add a few things, I've got all these buttons right here, but probably one of the most important things your teacher will ask you to add is going to be this whiteboard. So if your teacher wants you to record with a whiteboard, you're gonna click on board, and then you click on whiteboard, and it allows you to write on that whiteboard while you're recording. Some other tools that might help you here. I have some sticky notes, so I can actually write everything that I want to say. And I can have this right here on my right-hand side and read it as I'm recording, so I don't even have to remember what I want to say. I can write it all down. And then also, let's say I forget what my topic is. I can click on topic and move that over here. And I can even read the topic while I'm recording. And when people are watching my video, they won't see the stuff on my desktop. They just see me or my whiteboard recording. So once you're done recording, you record your stuff, you hit next. It lets you preview it. And it has you take a selfie. Sometimes your teachers won't let you take selfies, but for this one, it let me take a selfie. It lets me change my name if I want to. Now, you shouldn't change your name unless your teacher has asked you to. This way, they know who you are. You can have a title if the teacher lets you, and you can also have a link if the teacher lets you. I submit my video. I complete it. And this one says moderate, so it won't show up, but my teacher's got it. They will let us know if we are missing a video. So if you have any questions, reach out to your teacher, and they are more than happy to help you. Have a great day, everyone.